Hello and welcome back to my garage. In today's video we're going to replace a couple of springs and the top bearing of the strut. One of the reasons I'm going to do this because it's not the first time I am replacing front springs on a Peugeot Partner. This is a Peugeot Partner and these are just falling apart, so that's why I got a set of those also. One of the springs is broken. I believe it is pretty common on these cars, but also this is a really high mileage car. I believe it has now 310,000 kilometers, something in that area. So yeah, it is just gone. So enough said, let's get going. Well, this is the problem. As you can see, the spring has snapped somewhere here in the back, so the coils are together here, so that's no good. I did remove the whole brake assembly, but don't you worry, you don't have to do that. But I am going to change the brakes on this car. That's of course in another video. So you don't have to remove the brakes. The only thing you need to remove is this bolt right here where the hose of the caliper is hanging on to. And this is a 13. And then you can just pull it out, or at least you should be able to. But then again, you don't have to remove the caliper. Next up, you need to remove this bolt. This one can be a really pain to remove. Most of the time the nuts come off just like that, but you cannot remove the pin. If that happens, don't worry, you can keep it in its place. Just be sure that it unclamps. This is a 16, by the way. Let's see if we are able to remove this one. It is stuck in there. Don't waste your time on it. We need to do now is drive the knuckle downwards so that the shock will stays in its place and come out. And then just with a hammer just be careful with all the rust so you don't get anything in your eye. And as you can see, we are able to move it, so the clamping force of the nut is off. If it's still clamping on there, then you have really a problem. You have to cut the bolt out and maybe even drill it out or heat it up. I don't like heating stuff up with a strut in the way. Gases, heat, explosion and stuff. It's really bad for your skin, so don't do that. I am forgetting something. The stabilizer link has to come off. Do this before you remove the knuckle. Now it's all flopping around and you don't want to have that, but oh well. This is a T30, I believe, or 35. This is a T30. And what you want to do is clean that thing out as good as you can. You don't want to strip it. And these are really easy to round off. Especially when you don't insert the tool very well. The nut is a 16, at least in this case. Next up, we need to remove the computer because it's in the way of the nuts. These are 10, by the way. Next up, we need to remove these three bolts, and these are 13. Be sure you get a hold on the strut from beneath it, so it doesn't drop on the floor. As you can see, the spring is broken right here, right there. So it happens. Now we need to remove the spring. Normally you will never ever do it. Just take the nut off and up you went. Then you just have a projectile in your shop. Always use a set of these spring compressors or one of the bigger units, but because the spring is snapped, the tension is already off the strut, so I'm not really that scared that it's going flying. And still there is a little bit of tension, I feel it, but I think we're going to be fine. That was a little bit more than expected. Oh well. Of course, we are going to replace this bearing. This bearing isn't that bad. I've seen worse. But of course, we already have the parts. And it is a little bit of crusty. Just a chisel between it, and you can just take it off. It goes together like this. Have the strut, then the spring. Just be sure that you put it just here at the end, where it sits just nice and to the, well, thing. You got a washer that goes right in here. Then this top plate, and be sure that the spring rests against the slope right here. Then of course the bearing that just push in its place. Then the rubber piece goes on top of that. Then the cup Then the cup with the washer in it goes on there. And of course, the nut. But before we can do that, we need to compress the spring. Wearing some protection is never a bad idea. So now it's a matter of just feeding the strut back in its place. So now we can put back the computer. Next thing that you want to do is clean the bore, just with a rag or something, or maybe a little bit of sandpaper, and then spray it in with some grease, or I just use some WD-40. And now it's just a matter of getting it into its place. Be sure that there's a little bit of a notch right here. Hopefully I can show you that in a moment. There is a little notch just right here, just a little of a notch, a stud, just a, for lack of a better word, just a pimple, and that has to go into the slit right here in the back. So be sure to line those two up as good as you can. Sometimes you can just wrestle them into place. Other times you need a little bit of help. What I most of the time do is use a small jack and try to get it to the place I want it to go. And if it is all binding a bit like it does now, just give it a couple of taps. Most of the time it just slides in into a place. As you can see what did happen with me. Also, there is a little, well, square rectangle shaped right here. This has to correspond with the notch right here. And now it's just a matter of pushing it upward. And that's it, it's all the way down, so it's in. Next up is the stabilizer link. Sometimes you have to push the stabilizer down with a bar or something. But in this case, we can just pry it in there. And then of course the nut. And of course, we must not forget this nut. And for the last part, we need to install this bracket again. And normally you just put on the tire and you're done, but of course I'm going to do the brakes. But again, that will be in another video, probably linked somewhere there. So yeah, but that's it. And there you have it, how to change the springs, the front springs. Well, those are the only springs, because in the back they have torsion bars. So, oh yeah, and that's a nightmare to replace, I can tell you that from experience, and hopefully I never ever have to do that again. It is really a pain. But back to the springs. We replace the springs. It is straightforward. The only problem we encountered was that bolt in the back that connected the strut to the knuckle. Fortunately, the bolt wasn't frozen in both parts, so we could split it and get the strut out. Otherwise, it is a whole other story. We also did replace those top bearings. These bearings, weren't that bad. They could have done the job a little longer, but my experience is that these are just coming off and the balls are going everywhere, and yeah, that's not a great thing. So the only special tool you really need is one of these spring compressors. And I know most of you out there don't like these things and think these are dangerous, and I agree. It is never that I didn't feel safe around them, but maybe, as you can see it right here, I have these set as long as I can remember. I do consider them not really safe anymore. They're really worn, and I think I need to invest in a set of new ones or a better tool. I don't trust it as much as I did. Maybe I'm just getting a little bit more paranoid after the age is going up, but yeah, I do think it's time to buy another set. But this is the only tool you really need. Just don't do stupid things with them. Never ever stick your face in front of the strut, like something like that. That's just stupid. Just be safe. And that's it for today's video. I hope you really enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye. Ah, my ears.